before I talk about how my farmers used to put crops, I have slight problem with the term identity. Now, food crops cannot be the alternative to tobacco. Actually, tobacco invaded the land of the food crops. So actually, we are going back to what we were doing before. So it's not really, maybe according to FCTC, it may not fit into the right words, but this is, we call it food production, not only alternative. You can see already in the picture that when tobacco is a monocrop, if you talk about food crops, it's so colorful and so many different things. I will skip this. This is important thing, you know, when we, as we showed in our my earlier presentation, that how tobacco actually takes away the planting and harvesting time of other food crops. When we were planning to grow food crops, we, for those farmers who will not grow tobacco anymore, then we could not talk about only substitute crops. Substitute crops would mean that only like from November to March, when the tobacco is grown, then what crops are going to be. So because the other food crop planting and harvesting season does not match, we have to talk about transition crops. So there are two things. One is when you can see in this picture that when tobacco is in the field, October to March, and we are actually spending the money. So farmers are only spending the money. And then when tobacco, they are marketing, yes, they have some cash in hand. But from June to October, before the tobacco season, they are already indebted to the farmers. So it's advanced indebtedness. So, and on the other hand, when we are talking about substitute crops, which are mostly mixed food crops, they can be harvested and planted at different times of the year, and there is much less expenditure, but less maybe, not at a time income, but a continuous income. So its food is available at home and it's continuous. For tobacco, it is one time income, and then rest of the time it is indigenous. And the transition crops, which is particularly rice, jute, and vegetable, again we found that it is also much less expenditure and also continuous income. So this is very important thing we had to find out before we, when we were doing with the farmers. We even calculated, you know, how much money is required for tobacco farming, what is the return, and, you know, and we find that if they really calculated the human labor cost, which they don't, then actually the net return is very little. So that means tobacco is only profitable when family labor is used, unpaid family labor is used, and in fact, child labor is used. On the other hand, if you have food crops, and which is a mixed cropping, you know, we are not talking about monocrop here. We will, we have worked with the farmers, sat down with them, looked at the crop calendar of that area, and they were selecting the kind of crop would be, which would be important for them. For example, when in Kushtia, in one of the tobacco growing areas, they selected potato, maize, lentil, and coriander, they had consideration for income, like potato, they will not only eat it, they will sell it, maize, they will sell it, lentil, they will consume it, and it is good for the soil, because soil is already depleted. So, the, in terms of the selection of the crops, they were also thinking about how to make the soil better. Coriander was not only for selling as spices, but also pest control and also for good for crops. So this was very important that we had to really sit down with the farmers. So bean kind of crop was common because those were important for. And then, of course, the income is higher here because they do not, you know, when Adriana was also presenting his ecological farming, we are not talking about chemical-based farming here as a switchover. So we are not buying chemical fertilizer, we are not buying pesticides, so there is no cash involvement in terms of cost. It's family labor, you know, getting the seeds locally. And, you know, I will show you later that this is important, you know. We ask the farmers to draw a boundary of their village, and we said that, okay, the black spots are for tobacco, where they have no control because maybe they are the card holders, they will not switch. But those who wanted to switch, you know, these are different colors for different crops in the village. You can see that in one village where it used to be only tobacco, they could grow at least 9 to 11 different crops at the same time in different parts because land in the village is not similar. You know, some are a bit higher, some are near the river, some are, you know, so the crops they selected according to the location of the, or the land type. So it's very interesting, you know, that how many crops we can get. So you can see that although there are still tobacco in the nearby fields, these are mixed cropping fields. You know, there are, at the same time, they are growing 4 to 5, sometimes even 6 different crops to be harvested at different times. You know, some of these can be a good harvest as leaves. Some are, they wait till the potato is ready. So they are already earning income, eating it in the house, and also helping the family with food. But it has to be local seeds, no use of chemical fertilizer and pesticides. So the farmers are given training to make compost. There is Naya Kishi Andolon, which means New Agricultural Movement. It's a biodiversity-based farming. So in the nearby area, the farmers who are saving seeds, they are supplying the seeds. And you see the tobacco land is now much more beautiful with colorful, you know, like mustard and other things. So the transition crops are basically series of short duration food crops which will just cover the period before the substitute crops come. And, you know, and of course it has to be seasonal. And they try to improve the soil fertility. And the substitute crops are, we actually work with almost 304 farmers. Now they are increased to almost over 1,000. On their own initiative, because when they see that it can be done, they are coming to these people and and getting. So you can see so many different kinds of crops are coming in. So it's increasing the number, and this is we call it combination crop, you know, mixed crop or combination crop. It's not one single crop that we are shifting from tobacco to one single crop. It has to be a combination because it has to fulfill the need of cash income, it has to fulfill the need of food, it has to fulfill the need of soil management. So these are, you know, even though tobacco is here, next year this land is also under food crops, you know, coming gradually they are taking over. This is the assessment of the food crop, which is very important, that once they grow to food crops in the tobacco land, even if soil is degraded, but after growing food crops, they get better soil condition, food, fodder. Fodder is very important because they have to keep animals, and with tobacco they could not keep animals. Fuel, less labor cost, have food stock, better market for crops because they can sell in the market immediately, can keep the seed in hand and less production cost. But they need, as you see, the company gives all kind of support, and whereas for food crops, government has no support, we found that we call it institutional support. Whether it is an NGO or anybody, they have to be with the farmers for some time so that till they become, you know, sustainable. And so the trainings are there, and we strongly believe that farmers can shift food crops easily, and they want to do it. Women particularly do not want tobacco anymore. They want to keep the seeds. They used to keep seeds. And what we did also, we made an exchange program from one area farmers to the other area farmers, and they started exchanging seed with each other, and it was very good. At the government level, there was a Bangladesh Bank circular, no loan to tobacco farming. Ministry of Agriculture reduced fertilizer subsidy, and national budget has, you know, actions at the people's level. So we always, like on one food day and other days, we demand no cultivation of tobacco. And there is anti-tobacco women's alliance in Bangla, it is called Tabinaj, and particularly women's groups are against tobacco cultivation, not only against smoking and others. And there is a court case, you know, which banned almost that government land, or, you know, it has to be reduced, and they say it is causing a lot of problems in the area. So what we say that farmers should participate in this decision making. There needs institutional support for seed and training. Market support should be there. For potato, we found it a problem, you know, that if there is overproduction, surplus production, sometimes the price falls because there is too much supply. At that time, if there is no support for the farmers to keep it in the cold storage, then they lose. So, and we must keep the future of our children, and then grow food crops. And this is a very interesting poster. You know, the farmers are making, and they wrote in hand that tamak chash koro bondho. For the interpreters, you cannot translate now. My dudu bisher gondho. They wrote that this the child is smelling poison in the breast milk of the mother. And that poster I found really very important. And so for these children, for our future, please grow food crops, not tobacco.